Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you a really easy and quick technique to create any kind of checklist in Word with the help of AI. So let's just quickly whip onto the internet and onto ChatGPT. And down at the bottom here, I'm going to make a travel checklist for today, but you can create any that you like. So at the bottom here, I'm just going to type in travel checklist and press enter. So as you can see, a very comprehensive checklist has been created. Now, how to get this into Word? So all we need to do is click and drag all the information that we want. Keep going up, just push the cursor to the top. There we go. And I'm going to press Command or Control C on my keyboard, then go back over to Word. Cursor's at the top here, and all I'm going to do is go across to the Home tab and click Paste. Now, here is your checklist, but there's a few issues with it. First of all, it has been pasted across with lots of different formatting elements. So you can keep it like this if you're simply going to print it out and then you just cross off everything that you want. But if you want to create a table or a template of this, then I'll show you how to do that now. So you can see firstly, we've got a couple of spelling errors. So we'll just quickly right click onto those and take those out. Perfect. So once you've done that, we can either, if we select everything, and go to the Home tab and go to this icon here. This icon will clear all of the formatting in the document. If we click on that, you can see what happens now, which is great, but also we don't know which lines of this had those definitive sections or the section titles. So let's go back, Command or Control Z, and what we can do is just go through each different section. So highlight this section and just click on the clear formatting, and then we're left with the titles. Okay, so we've done that, but we've maintained all of these different titles. So now we can go through and do the same with the titles. Now I'm going to do this because when it comes to copy and pasting this stuff into a table, it just makes the whole process so much easier. So I'm going to go along and I'm going to take out these two dots, just press delete. I'm going to highlight that section, then click on clear formatting, but then go straight to bold and make that bold. So again, I'm going to do the same here, take out those two dots, highlight the title, clear formatting, and press bold. And I'll do that for the rest of the document. Now I could try and select all of this and put it into the table, go to insert table, click on the drop down and select convert to table. I can select two columns to try and get as much onto the table as possible and then auto fit to contents and click OK. If I do that, you can see what happens here, and that's not quite what we're going for. So it is a bit of a long-winded process, but just bear with me. So I'm going to go back, Command or Control Z, and I'm actually going to open a new document. So go to Home and just click Create. And now I have a new document. So I'm just going to reduce the size of my screens and show you exactly how we can do this relatively easily. So in here, I'm just going to hit the return key. So I've got a space above my table. Go to Insert, Table, click on the drop down, and then I'm going to select four rows and then go right down to the bottom. Okay, so what we need to do is we've got the first row here, and then we want a checkbox to allow you to tick that box, and then another one over here. So to ensure these two columns are the same width, we can just select them all, then go to layout, and then on width, we can just select one and press enter. And again here, just select width, press one and then enter. So those two columns are the same width. So if we select this top row, then go to layout and click merge. So go over to here and let's choose travel documents. Copy that, Command or Control C. Go over to that first row, Command or Control V to paste it. And then you can see it's made another line. So just press the return key to go back up. go to home and go to center. And then you can also make this uppercase if you want to. Go to this icon here and select uppercase. Now the next trick here, because we've got two columns, because we want to put as much information on one page as possible rather than just having one long list, then we've got two columns. So if we go over to our travel documents here and our list, so below here we've got five different lines of information. So we can split that, because it's an odd number, we can just split it three and two. So I'm going to select the top three lines, Command or Control C, go over to our table, select three rows and press Command or Control V, and do exactly the same with this one here. Select these two, Command or Control C, and then select two rows and then paste them into those two rows, Command or Control V. Then go down to the next row here, select it, go to layout, select merge. Don't worry, I'm not going to run through, I will speed the video up. I'm not going to go and do all of this for the entire document. But just to give you a second go, select that text, go into this row here, click paste, Command or Control V. Let's take out that return key and then select the text, go to home. I'm going to make it uppercase and just center it. And then to make more rows, because you're going to need a lot more rows, if you just click on the bottom row, or any row, it doesn't matter, go to layout and then go to this icon here that says insert rows below and just keep clicking until you go down to the bottom. And then you can go ahead and once again, if we just have a look at this section, again, we've got five options, so we can split this three and two. Again, select it, copy it, go over, select three rows and paste, and then two rows, select two rows and then paste. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do all of this and speed up the video and then come back at the end. I'm going to make a few tweaks to this to make it look better. I'm going to put a title at the top and then I'm going to show you how to save this as a template. Okay, so we finally got all of our information into our table. So once again, I'm just going to take out these rows at the bottom, right click, delete cells, okay. And for me, we're never going to get all of this information on one page unless we made the font really, really small. So we'll leave it to two pages. But what I will do is show you how you can just tidy up this table a little bit more. So first of all, let's go to the top. I'm going to put my cursor at the top here and just press the return key a few times to give me a little bit of extra space to put the title in at the top. And also these rows are quite close together. They're quite tight. So I'm just going to give it a little bit more space. So select the whole table with this top left square, go to layout and go to the height here. So in here, we're going to put 0.7 and press enter. Now you can also go along to each title and click center and make sure all of those titles are centered. And then if you want to, you can increase the size of the text. If you want to go to the home tab, click on this icon here, which is increase font size. And again, you can do that with all of the titles. And then finally, if you're happy with your checklist, let's put a title in at the top. I don't generally put the title in here using the normal typing because I want to utilize this whole space, and that is at the moment in the headers and footers. So I can't type, so I'm going to go to insert, text box, click on the drop down and select draw text box, then just click and drag out a text box. And in here I'm just going to type travel checklist and then go to the home tab. If I deselect it, you can see we've got this black border. You can keep that if you want to, but I'm going to get rid of it. So select it, go to shape format and go to this icon here, click on the drop down and select no outline. And then I'm going to go to home. Then I'm going to go to the increase font size tool here and just keep clicking till you're happy with the size of the text. Then I'm going to go to center to make sure it's centered. Then I'm going to go to shape format, go to align, click on the drop down and make sure the whole thing is aligned to the center of the page. And now I can simply use my arrow keys to nudge that. And I'm just going to go to the home tab and select underline. Let's deselect. And just finally, if you want to tweak the titles a bit more, let them stand out, just select the row, go to table design, shading here, click on the drop down, and you can just select any kind of shading. And once again, because that color is selected, you can just simply click on the row, click back up onto the gray, and it will change all of those headings. That just allows it to stand out a little bit more, potentially make it a little bit more professional. If you want to split the table so toiletries isn't split across two pages, then select the toiletries, or select this row here, go to layout and go to split table. You can see the cursor's over here now. Just press the return key and nudge it down onto the next page. And you can actually nudge it down so it lines up with the table on the left hand side on page one. So once you're happy with that, you want to save it out. So you can save it as three different documents: a Word document, a PDF, or a template. So go to File. If you want to save it as normal, just go to Save or Save As. If you want to save it as a PDF, go to Save As. Click on this menu here and go down to PDF, and then just click Save. If you want to save it as a template, save it as a template. You can change your title here. Make sure you're on templates here. If not, click on the drop down and select templates. And again, file format must be Microsoft Word templates. And again, if not, just click on that drop down and click Save. If you save it as your template, to find it, when you open your software or go to Home, you'll find templates at the top. Go to More Templates, and then you'll find you're in Personal. These are all the templates you've created or can create. Scroll down and you'll find your travel checklist is there. Just click on it and it will open a brand new document. Perfect. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.